Hello, everyone, and welcome to Week 7 of the Bommarito Automotive Prep Zone Game of the Week. Tonight, we're at Francis Howell Central, home of the Spartans, where they host the Francis Howell Vikings. Along with former Tennessee Titan Isaac Byrd and sideline reporter Angela Sharp, I'm Todd Blackstock, and we're having a great time out here at Francis Howell Central. It's a big night, senior night. The weather's great. Should be a great matchup, Isaac.
Two teams going in two different directions. Howell Central comes in dropping their last four games in a row, and with a defense that has given up on average of 40 points a game during that span. Howell comes in 5-2, very confident, and they believe they have a team that can make a deep run in this year's playoffs.
Right now, we're going to look at the Elite Football Academy player to watch of the game, and we're going to start out with Howell Central tonight, Isaac, and they've got a pretty special quarterback that really likes to light it up.
Yes, Jackson Burke is a big, strong-arm quarterback. He's very accurate in the pocket, and he has great pocket presence. He comes in with 23 touchdowns and over 1,800 yards.
And one of the reasons, Francis Howell, the Vikings are 5-2 is because of a running back that's really putting up some big numbers as well.
Yes, Alex Jones may not be the biggest back we've seen this year, but he's just as explosive. Only 5'6", 170, but he's really tough to bring down. He has great balance, coordination, and speed, and averaging over 6 yards a carry.
Unbelievable. All right, football fans, pull up a chair and get ready for the Bommarito Automotive High School Prep Zone Game of the Week coming up next.
I was sick of working dead-end jobs. I wanted to have a career. Battle Eye gave me the hands-on experience to build my future. Them teachers are very good.
The purpose of them coming to Battle Eye is to learn a trade. As an instructor, I'm gonna be there for them.
They just made me feel like a brand new person.
He's been working with me for some years, and I'm proud of him and the things that they have instilled in him.
I want to follow my dad's footsteps, but now I figured out through Battle Eye, I could be better than my dad. Battle Eye had really changed my life.
We want to thank Connections to Success, breaking the cycle of poverty through hope, resources, and a plan, and their support for local families.
All right, so the Lions' choice coin toss has been completed, and the home team wins. And it looks like Francis Howell is going to defend the left side of the field. So I'm not sure exactly where I'm standing right now, if it's north, south, east, or west, Isaac, but we're going to have a lot of fun out here tonight, and Howell Central is going to get the ball first, so we'll find out immediately how they're going to go with the running back situation. But, you know, it's all about the aerial attack with the Spartans anyway.
Yeah.
And getting ready to tee it off is John Recca. He comes up with a run up and the kick. We're underway. Keon Waters, Dylan Thaxton back for Central. And that's Dylan Thaxton. He brings it up close to the 30-yard line. And the Spartans will start off first down, 10 yards to go, going right to left on your screen.
Big possession here, even though it's the first possession. You really want to jump out in front. That's going to be the key for the Spartans. If they can jump out in front and play with a lead, they haven't played with much of a lead at all this year. Most of their games, they've been trying to come from behind. That's why they put up a lot of passing yards in the second half.
They got wide receivers split to both sides. Got Thaxton on the near side. Shotgun formation for Burke. And we're ready for action. Week 7 underway. Thaxton in motion. Burke back to pass. He looks on the right side. He's got a man and in and out of the hands of number 22. And that was Adam Lewis. And right now we're going to go down to Angela Sharp on the sideline.
Hey, thanks, guys. I am down here on the sidelines. I've got the Central cheerleaders. I've got some of the Howell cheerleaders. They're ready to go. They're all celebrating Breast Cancer Awareness Month. They all got their pink on. We like that. Plus, it's senior night here for Central. But, you know, all the records are out the window. This right here, this is rivalry. And we're going to find out which school has the most spirit tonight. We're going to figure that out. We are streaming live on KSDK.com live. And, of course, you can check us out on Channel 11 Sunday morning at 10 a.m. Back to you, Todd and Isaac.
All right, Burke to the left side, a little play action. The intended receiver right there was Number six, Micah Skibo, is going to get a lot more action tonight, and that's going to bring up a third down for the Spartans.
Yeah, this is one of the things that they love to do is put Burke right there on the run. It really was a screen they was trying to set up there just to try to get the ball into third and short. It's really important for this offense to play in third and short and not third and long the way it is now.
Three wide receivers split to the far side, one on the near side, empty backfield. Burke back to pass, two-step drop, guns it over the right side and over the intended receiver. That'll bring up fourth down. A little bit too much mustard on that pass from Burke.
Yeah, he actually had Dylan Thaxton wide open, number four. He ran a very good route, the junior, 6'1", 170, ran a very good out route and was wide open. He had it right there for the first down, wasn't able to complete the pass.
It's interesting, it's fourth down right now, and they're going for it. They don't look to have a punting game.
Well,
deep in their own territory. Burke back to pass. He's going long down the right side. And he's got a man at the 30, 35, 10, 5, touchdown! Nathan Garf comes up for the fourth down. About a 70-yard touchdown, Isaac. And I tell you what, I guess they felt like they had nothing to lose coming in at 2-5. Why not go for it? Nathan Garf has been a big stud on this team all year long. And that, I believe, is his 11th touchdown of the season.
Shocking. That's all you can say about the play call. It's simply shocking. Instead of punting the ball and trying to flip the field, they decide to go for it, throw it deep, and actually hit him. Well, that was awesome. Looks like they're going to go for two here.
All right, so they're set up. Skiba switches over. It looks like Burke's going to take it. Now he stops and pops, and he hits in the end zone. Micah Skiba for 2 points. That makes it 8-0 Central as they come out. Unbelievable. Let's take a look at the touchdown here in just a moment.
Exactly what you wanted to do if you were Central. Going for it on fourth down. Going for it right here on fourth down. Burke stands in nice and tall, and look, he flicks the ball and delivers a beautiful ball. Hits him right in stride, right in the chest, and now the speed takes over down the sideline for the touchdown, and that's going to put him up 6-0. A two-point conversion puts him up 8-0, and in a rivalry game, these are the type of things you have to be aware of. Kind of trick plays, just like this two-point conversion, off-balance set to the left when it comes to the offensive line, a fake run up the middle, and then like more of a pop pass right over the top for a touchdown.
Wow, there's a nice shot right there. Burke, number 12, he had some kind words to say about his father, and they do a squib kick. It's what we were kind of heard about in the scouting reports before the game. Squibs it down to about the 28-yard line where Dean McGuire picks it up. McGuire's the quarterback for Francis Howell. They're going to take over first down, 10 yards to go with 11:32 to go here in the first quarter.
And the thing about Central, I mean, as you said, you know, we've heard about their kicking. Sometimes most of the time, they will do that squib kick. And even on when they score those touchdowns, most of the time, they will go for two-point conversions. And they did both of those so far. Now they have the lead at 8-0.
It's like, what do you have to lose? So here comes the Vikings. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. Shotgun formation. Ball's handed off the left side. Busting up the middle, number 21, Alex Jones. We talked about him pregame. And there you see it live.
Very explosive. Very explosive little guy. He does a really good job of hiding behind the line. He's only 5'6", maybe 170 pounds. Because he's so low, the defensive line has a really tough time of finding him. Did a really good job of bursting through there on that first play.
It seems like there's a new trend where running backs are kind of hesitating and waiting for a hole to develop, not hitting the hole like they did back in the day. Any truth to that, Isaac?
Yeah.
I think it's Le'Veon Bell.
Yeah, it really depends on the play call. If the play call is set to have a couple of the linemen, maybe the guard and tackle pull, then that running back is going to have to pause a little bit to let those linemen pull from right to left or left to right and get up and get on their block before he hit the hole. On that play, though, that was just a pure dive right up the middle, and he just hit it hard. Looks like he picked up 10 yards and the first down.
Yeah, right on it, as we got a nice camera angle there. Great job by our videographers here this evening as we're just underway. And if you're just tuning in, Fourth down and 10, a 70-yard bomb from Burke to Garth. That's Garth's 11th touchdown of the season.
Yes, and when they throw the ball deep, he's their guy. He's their speed guy. He has really good hands, runs really good routes. It was good to see Burke, after missing that throw on third down, come back and fourth down and complete one.
And that puts Garth at almost 700 for the year. And this time the quarterback's going to keep it, and he's spinning around, and the central defense is pushing them back. And Dean McGuire goes down. Looks like a little bit of a loss on that play.
Absolutely. We're going to look at number 90, Luke Ezell, the defensive lineman, 6'1", 185. Watch him get in and gets really low. Good job there. And then here comes the help to make sure he doesn't go much further.
All right, second down. It's a handoff up the middle. Bowling just for a couple of yards right there. The central defense does a real nice job there. I see Luke Ezell. That's a guy we're probably going to be saying his name quite a bit this evening as well. Number 48 right there. Nice shot of him. That's Danny Morgan, linebacker. This brings up third down, and I'll call it 8 for the Vikings. McGuire stands back at the 35-yard line, shotgun formation. Three-step drop. He's got nice protection. Goes over the middle, and it's caught. Caught at the 45-yard line, up past the first down. And a nice positive play right there for the Vikings. It looks like that was number 7, Dayton Dalton, with the catch right there.
Very good job. When Dalton caught this ball, he did not have the first down. He's going to run up here. Here he is in the slide. He's going to run an end cut right around 8 yards. And he really, when he catches it here, he doesn't have the first down. Now he starts making his move. Outruns one guy, gets around the edge, then picks up that first down. So really good job of running after the catch to get that first down.
That's his 22nd catch of the year. And here comes a run up the middle again, juking and jiving, and getting a few yards right there on the carry, as that looks like Alex Jones. And Dalton, this is he's got 4 touchdowns on the year. They really spread it around with the Vikings. There's no really big superstar. Joe Farron's got 243, 17 receptions. Kimes got 292 yards. Johnny Crone, 250 yards on 17 receptions. So they really spread the ball around well. Second down and 5 for the Vikings. McGuire stands about the 49-yard line. And there's a whistle on the play. The play took a little while to develop. And it's a timeout by the Vikings. And Isaac, that looks like they didn't like what they saw. All right, right now we'll take a quick timeout with the Spartans leading the Vikings 8-0. We'll be right back.
It was a place like Harris Stowe that took a chance on me as a first-generation college student from a single-parent household. A place like Harris Stowe provided me an educational opportunity that allowed me to be the youngest college president in the country. Harris Stowe has amazing degree programs. We have one of the most quality, affordable educations in this region. Small classroom environment, family environment, very welcoming to all students, and be prepared to be a global leader in a global society, Harris Stowe is the place for you.
For more than a century, the St. Louis Carpenters Union has shaped St. Louis. Through trusted alliances, we deliver skilled professional craftspeople, while our business partners provide the kind of quality jobs that keep our economy humming. It's a blueprint that has worked since 1882. A career in union carpentry means great pay, exceptional benefits, and professional skills training unmatched in the industry. We are 20,000 members strong, and we work for St. Louis. Visit carpdc.org to learn more.
Our thanks to Fisher's Pro Line Sports, outfitting your team from head to toe and a strong supporter of high school sports.
Hey, welcome back. Beautiful night out here in St. Charles County. The Vikings and the Spartans. And here's a pass over the middle. Oh, just over the outstretched arms right there of number 6, Joe Farron. McGuire was just a little bit too strong on that as Farron was wide open.
Yeah, McGuire has to. This is a play that McGuire has to complete. Good route here. He just runs the post route in the corner, just drops him. He's looking for safety help. Safety's not there, and McGuire just missed him. That is 6 points and a touchdown if he's able to get it to him. He didn't have any pressure. He just missed him with the throw.
I don't know what Brandon Stahl, number 32, is looking at, but here comes Jones up the middle, pushing towards a first down, and he's really close to the 40-yard line. We'll see where they spot it.
It's one of the things that Francis Howell will do tonight. They'll take a shot or two on first down. If they miss it, they'll come back with a running play, knowing that their running game is really good, really strong, and that should put them in third and short. So they missed it on first down. First down should have been a touchdown. They run it the next play, and they and really good, maybe even 10 yards in the first down.
Yeah, they're still looking at it right now, which is pretty interesting. It looks to me like it's a first down, but here comes the chain gang right now, and why not bring him out and make it official?
I think he has it by a ball. Okay, half a ball.
Yep, definitely got it. So first down for the Vikings. 9:03 to go here in the first quarter. Week 7 of the Bommarito Automotive Group High School Prep Zone Game of the Week. Isaac Bird, Todd Blackstock bringing the action. We'll be going down to interviews and reports from our sideline reporter, Angela Sharp, throughout the game. This is a quick fake to Jones and a quick hitter to the left side, completed out of bounds. Pretty nice pass right there. And let's take a look at the replay.
Yeah, Dawson Kim is wide open here. Very good fake here, turns his shoulders and throws it out to Dawson, who runs a 5-yard hitch route, catches the ball, gets upfield. That's a really good play on first down to bring up second down and short. Now the playbook is wide open here. You can run it, you can throw it, anything you want to do on second and short. This is where they want to be all night.
And they fake it to Jones, and they throw it out to the far side. Once again, this one was dropped on the far side by Dawson Kime. Kime on the year, 13 receptions, 292 yards. But that last reception should put him up about 300 for the season.
Yeah, that ball was just dropped. It was exactly the same play. Once these corners are backing off of central, they're playing about 8 yards off, giving you the 5-yard hitch. They try to take it again, and he just dropped it.
Viking ball, 3rd and 3, 8:20 to go in the first. Time hand off to Jones. He scoots up inside the 20, 10, 5, touchdown. Alex Jones, 33-yard touchdown with 8:14 to go in the first.
Boy, what patience and then explosiveness that he has going through the hole. Watch him here. He hesitates just a little bit to the right. Third down, you think they may pass. He's going to go to the right, sticks his foot in the ground, goes back up the middle, and then he just burst right through. Again, being so short, those linebackers really can't find him. And then once he gets in open space, though, he's really tough to bring down because he's elusive and he has speed.
Shades of Barry Sanders there. And the kick is up, and it's good. And right now we've got a special guest down with sideline reporter Angela Sharp.
That's right. I have Stephen with Connections to Success filling in for Napoleon today.
Yes, yes, absolutely. Big shoes to fill. I'm here to talk about Connections to Success this evening. What we do is we inspire individuals to realize their dreams and to achieve economic independence by providing hope, resources, and a plan. I work for Connections doing a community outreach, but I also know the organization from another standpoint. I was actually a participant that came through the Connections program. And when I came through, I had no hope, no resources, and I definitely didn't have any plan. Everything that Connections promised that they could do for me, they actually followed through. They had life coaching, mentorship, the personal and professional development classes that we have. The Monday Night Connects that we have, that you can come up and stay engaged with everything that we have. There's so many things that we offer in the program here in the St. Charles area. Transportation was one thing that was really huge around here in St. Charles. And we provide transportation for all the services that we offer. And I will say that without Connections being in my life, I definitely probably wouldn't be down the path that I'm at today.
I love that you're so passionate about it, and you were a participant. And then now you work there. How can someone get involved with Connections to Success?
You can get involved with Connections to Success through volunteer, mentorship. The phone number is 636-940-8027. You can always email us at www.connectionstosuccess.org or me personally, SJOHANNSEN at connectionstosuccess.org.
Perfect. Well, we're glad to have you here at the Bommarito High School Prep Zone Game of the Week. Back to you, Todd and Isaac.
All right, nice job, Angela. Connections to Success. Sounds like a great organization supporting high school football in the St. Louis and St. Charles area. And the Metro East as well. We don't want to leave them out. While we were away, we had a couple of penalties. And right now it's second down. Here's Burke back to pass. He escapes the pocket and gets up past the line of scrimmage. Gets a yard or two. That's going to bring up third down at about five. On that, a couple penalties while we were away. And let's take a look at the replay.
Burke is a very capable runner. You really have to corral him. He's really big and strong. He wants to throw the slant right there to the right. Didn't like it. Pulls it down. And is going to get up the field. And as a quarterback, you got to know when that journey is over. You got four defenders there. Get down on the ground. You're not going to be able to run over all four of them. He gets down, and now he's going to bring up a third and five.
And though a referee blows a whistle, and it looks like a timeout for Howell Central right there. And looks like Keon Waters is the go-to guy early in this game on the Central side, as we mentioned earlier. And right now we'll step away. We'll be back with more action right after this.
This telecast is made possible through the support of Me2U Game Truck. Let our luxury video game truck be part of your next party.
And here we have it, first down. Burke pulls it back. He's got Isla, in and out of his hands. He just looked left, unbelievable. Ball hit him right in the numbers, Isaac, and he had some room to run.
Yeah, the passing game just a tad bit off on this possession. It's the receiver screen again. He's open. Just get it to him. It's right in his hands, and he looks away, and that ball hits him in the hands, not just once, but twice. Hands, face mask, then hands.
Here's a shot of Outlaw. He's back in there. One of the receivers split to the near side, one to the far side. Burke doesn't mess around. He comes back with Paxton. Inside the 30, 25. There he goes, down the sideline. Five, touchdown, Dylan Paxton. 39-yard touchdown.
This is a great job of outflanking the defense. The defense doesn't move over enough players to cover the receivers. They had a safety deep who should have probably moved up a little bit closer. You see, you got three receivers at the bottom, but only two defenders. There's one defender getting blocked, and the safety stays back. Now the safety has to make this play. You must make this tackle. He's not able to. Great stiff arm right there by Daxton. Then that was the strength, and then you saw the speed.
Max Heffner could have made that tackle right there, and they go for two. Wow. And they get it again. Unbelievable. Wow. Keon Waters comes out and pulls that one down for the two-point conversion. Francis Howell Central here in the first quarter is making some noise against the 5-2 Vikings.
Not just the throw, but the catch. The execution was absolutely perfect here. Now watch Burke rolls to his right. This is a design roll to the right, allowing his receivers. One is rolled, running the out route. There's the back corner right there. Good throw. Great job of reaching up and grabbing that ball with his hands. Waters pulls that ball down for the two-point conversion. That gives him a 16-7 lead.
You know, you read the statistics and you see some plays, but until you actually come out and see this young man, Burke, Jackson Burke, throwing the run, he's got great accuracy, he's mobile, he's big, he's solid, he's a good athlete. And I tell you what, this is fun to watch. And you see a kid in the making right here that could possibly play some serious football down the road.
Yeah, and we haven't even seen Burke take off and run. He's such a big kid. You know, when he runs now, you better bring it, because he's well over 200 pounds. It was like a squib kick here on onside.
Yeah, it looks like, I'm saying it's showing Williams, a blue Williams on the kick there, but they swim it down there. I'm not sure. They didn't catch anybody by surprise. I think everybody in the house knew they were going to do it. But why? They must be afraid of some of the deep men from the Vikings, just to give them field position like that, just kind of hand it to them.
Yeah, especially when you know your defense is already up against it, against a team that can really score. Now you're giving the ball at the 50-yard line.
All right, here comes Alex Jones on the near side. He spins down, gets about 5 yards. He's upended right there. A nice tackle brought down by Skibo.
Good job by Skibo coming in from his corner position. Look at the feet, look at the balance, look at the vision. Sees him, here's Skibo, watch him get really low. Good job of getting really low. Whenever you have a back that is short, you have to get just as small as him to make a play.
So Skibo makes the play, and then Kreider comes in for the kill. And here's another run, first down right now. Alex Jones, he brings it down to the 35-yard line. For the Vikings, starting out this possession with fantastic field position after a kind of an onside squib kick type situation. And they move the ball all the way down to about the 37-yard line, where it's first down, 10 yards to go, 3:51 to go here in the first quarter. This time they fake it to Jones. Pass is complete at the 30-yard line. And the wide receiver was hit immediately. And the wide receiver on that play was Joe Farron. Let's take a look, Isaac, at the replay.
Really good job of faking the ball right there to the right. That holds the backers. Then you throw it right over the backer's head. This is a very good design play. You fake it to bring up the linebackers. Linebackers come up. You simply throw it right over their head for very good completion on first down. Brings up second and short.
Second down, 3 yards to go for the Vikings. McGuire takes it himself, runs around the right side. He's got the first down. He pushes down inside the 25. First and 10 for the Vikings with 3 minutes to go, 3:03 to go here in the first quarter.
Yeah, with an offense as good as Francis Howell's offense is, I'm really, I don't know why you would even try the onside kick and give them the ball back, especially when you have the lead, giving the ball at the 50-yard line. Now, once this Howell offense starts to roll, they're really tough to stop.
First down, 10 yards to go. Man in motion on the far side. And they hand it off around the left side. Turning the corner and burning down towards the end zone. Is he in? Looks like he stopped just short. And that's number 7, Dalen Dalton, who spins all the way down inside the 5-yard line to about the goal line, Isaac.
And
first and goal right now for the Vikings with 2:34 to go here in the first quarter.
Just a very good play, speed running around the edge. And this offensive line of Francis Howell is doing a really good job. I mean, they are big and they are strong. They're number 77, Tyler Walker, goes 6'2", 3'10". At left tackle.
Oh, that's a great shot right there.
And that's where they go, right behind him.
And they go into the end zone for the touchdown. And that makes it 16-13, Hal Cetron. And here's what set up that touchdown.
Watch the speed run right around the edge. They put him in motion just to start his speed. And then right around there, it's good job cutting right up the middle. And now once he gets through, it's real tough to bring him down. He gets all the way to the 1 yard line, close to getting it in. Then they punch it in to play next, the very next play.
And the PAT is up and good. And the score. Score 16-14. Hal Central, let's take a look at the touchdown.
Look at the lineman, real big. Look at big number 77. They go right behind him, Tyler Walker, and he puts it into the end zone. And I believe that's his fourth touchdown of the year.
All right, great camera work there on the slow motion. Now it's time for the run up and the kick. Rekha boots it high and taking about the 8-yard line. The ball is dropped. Picked up at the 15-20 and up to about the 27-yard line right there. Thaxton brings it back up where the Spartans will take over. First down, 10 yards to go with 2:17 to go here in the first quarter.
And this offense is really, really rolling now for Francis Howell. Here's the kickoff. He was just a little bit anxious here. Watch him just put his head down just right there without securing the ball first, but he's got a good awareness, gets up the field. Once you drop that ball, the timing is off, so all you want to do is just get up the field as quick as you can.
All right, Burke stands back at the 22-yard line. This time he hands it right up the middle. Look at that guy, right up there, 40-yard line, up to about the 44-yard line for the Spartans, Keon Waters. So Keon Waters, we wondered if he would be the guy tonight to replace Haddon, and here's the replay.
Doing a really good job. Look at this double team on the nose tackle. Sprints right through the hole. Good job of vision getting up the field and getting as much as you can. Those are the kind of plays that Central is going to need all night. Plays that really, they call them chunks, 10, 15-yard plays.
All right, they got the serious spread offense going here. They fake it to Waters and bring it down here to number 22. That goes to Ashad Blue Williams.
Right bounds by the team.
And it looks like it'd be very close to a first down. We'll see the spot. It's spotted just outside the 43-yard line. It looks like a Spartan first down.
I really like this offense. They're mixing in very well tonight with the running game, with the deep passing game, and the short passing game. This offense has everything working so far tonight.
Burke looks left. Looks right. He's got a big rush. He gets a nice block by Waters, throws it down. It's caught, but it looks like it's out of bounds on that play. But once again, Burke buys himself some nice time. He gets a little bit of help in the backfield with Waters. And that's going to bring up second down and 10.
Yeah, Burke does a really good job of just buying time. He does this a lot. He has really good footwork, and he knows his arm is strong enough to where if he's on the run and has to make a throw downfield, even across his body, he's confident that he'll be able to put some zip on that ball and get it to where he wants to go.
All right, you've got wide receivers split. Three to the far side, one to the near side. Keon Waters in the backfield with Burke. Fakes it to Waters, and it looks like the ball might have been tipped, as it was incomplete. That'll bring up third down and 10. For the Spartans.
Yeah, I'm just wondering when Francis Howell was going to start bringing the linebackers. They haven't done it all night. That time, Mike and Sam came right up the A-gap and put pressure on the quarterback. You may start seeing more of that, because as Burke starts to get comfortable in this game with some time to throw the ball, he can really pick you apart. So you may start to see Howell start to bring those backers.
Connor Ryball in the ball game, number 8 here on the near side. You know, they're trying to get him involved. This one goes to Waters. Waters gets down. He shifts his field a little bit to the left. Spun down. Gets to about the 42-yard line. That's going to bring up about fourth down and 8 yards for the Spartans right now with 1 minute and 10 seconds to go and counting here in the first quarter.
If you're going to bring pressure, this is the time to do it. You do not want Burke to sit there on fourth down and have his options of who you want to throw it to. You may see these linebackers come right back up that A-gap again to put pressure on Burke.
All right, Ryball on the near side, three wide receivers on the far side, naked backfield. Burke goes to the far side. He plays pitch and catch. The ball is caught. And very, very close to the first down as Thaxton gets it. He maneuvers down there and doesn't look like they made the first down. So, and right now we're going to go down to our sideline reporter, Angela Sharp.
Hey, I am down here with Maurice from Dead On Sports. Week after week you're here. We're very happy to have you as the Bommarito High School Prep Zone Game of the Week. Now, we've been talking about football, but you have other versatile things we can do.
We actually, at Dead On Sports, we're actually into not just football, we're into baseball. We use the targets for the same target can be used for baseball as well as we have our own strike zone, but we also do volleyball, soccer, and golf now.
So if you're into any sport, you have a product that can help kind of focus them in.
Get you dead on accurate in any sport out there.
I love it. Dead on accurate. Now, I know the quarterback there across the way there, he uses your product.
Right. He trains with Matt at the elite. A lot of these guys do. I mean, pretty much everywhere we go, you see the quarterbacks that train at elite. Real versatile at elite. Matt does a great job. He uses it for several different things. You can set up your routes, time the quarterback from the time he takes the ball to the time he hits that route. Then your receiver has to be there. So you kind of time everybody out. other things that you can do with this, like using an off season. It's great product for in the gym on the off season, so your quarterback can practice his throws. All that's building confidence when you're building that accuracy, and that confidence is a big deal. These kids today, everybody plays video games, so they're watching a target move around on a video game while they're doing something else, waiting for the next shot to come up. Same kind of thing we did. We just brought it into reality.
I like that. Where can somebody find your product and Dead On Sports?
You can find us at anybody that Shutt deals with. We have a contract with them, BSN, Kurt Smith in Belleville, MVP in Camden, Missouri, deadonsports.com, and Amazon.
Perfect. And back to you, Todd and Isaac.
All right, thanks a lot, Angela. And while we were away, a nice pitch and catch from Burke. Excuse me, pitch and catch from the quarterback as we look at Alex Jones right now and Dean McGuire with a very, very nice pass down the middle. And we're going to go down and take a look at some of the replays that we missed on that last one. Isaac?
Very good fake here. Looks down the field. Good job with the protection. He knew he was going to get hit, but stood in there. Look at this throw. It's very accurate. It's right between the both safeties, right in the hands of the receiver. Very good job getting that ball down the field. That's one of those chunk yard plays that they really want to have tonight.
And a touchdown saving tackle there by the defensive back, number 34, Trennan Curry. And that will do it for the first quarter. The score, Francis Howell Central 16, the Francis Howell Vikings 14. We'll take a break. We'll be back for second quarter action after this.
When Chris graduates with his liberal arts degree, his starting salary is $25,000. That's if he can find a job. When Steve graduates from MTC Truck Driving School, he'll work for a national company at $50,000 a year. Which route would you take? Hop on at beatrucker.com.
This telecast is made possible by the support of Microsoft, helping people and businesses realize their full potential.
As we come back, it's a touchdown for the Vikings. Very nice right there. We're going to take a look at it right here. Looks like Dean McGuire very involved in this play. Isaac?
Very good fake. This is a designed running play. Right up the middle. Once he fakes it to the left, those linebackers going to their right, thinking that it's going to be a running play, and he runs right where the spot that they lead from, right up the middle. That is a great design and a great job, excellent job by that offensive line and getting that quarterback up the middle for the touchdown.
And the PAT is good. That makes it 21-16 Vikings. And the Spartans came out quick. They came out with a 70-yard touchdown right off the bat, Isaac, and they score another one. And right now we're going to take another look at the touchdown.
It's all about the... Well, this is the touchdown here. Look at the line go off to the left. Everyone is going for the running back, and he just keeps the ball and goes right up the middle. This is a very good design play right up the middle. Now it's going to be 21-16 in the lead, right where they want to be. Defense isn't playing that great, but they do have the lead, and they're really exactly where they want to be right now.
I think so too. As far as the Vikings have been very patient. This Recca kicks this one down. It's very high, got a lot of loft on it. It's taken up about the 22, and the receiver battling, it's Adam Stahlschmidt, 5'8", 145. He didn't want to go down, Isaac.
Now you have Central now with the ball again. They are down 21-16, so now they're behind. will their offensive philosophy change here? Are they going to start to just try to move the ball up the field quickly with some throwing, or they're going to continue to try to mix this thing up, have some balance in their offense? And I think that's really the best way to go, is to have some balance in their offense and try to have a long drive for a touchdown in this possession.
And maybe take some time off the clock, because they pass on every down, so they don't ever seem to work the clock. So right now, Burke fakes it, keeps it himself, and he gets the first down as he pushes up the 38-yard line. He must have heard me right there talking about some possession, and you as well. Running some time off the clock. Let's take a look, guys.
One of the things I really like from Burke, being such a big, you know, a very big, strong player, he's over 210 pounds. He's pointing the way through, and he's not going out of bounds. I mean, he's looking to get extra yards. He's real tough to bring down and a very, very tough player. One of those players that you really want to have leading your team.
All right. Burke stands back at his 35-yard line. Movement on the Vikings side. Looks like left defensive end on the Vikings side, John Recca, who's also the kicker. And he was a little excited on that play. And it's going to make it first down and five for Central.
One of the ways to slow down a very aggressive defense is to use your hard count. And that's very important for Burke to do tonight. You don't just go on one every play.
Yeah,
go
exactly.
On two, go on three, and see if you can pick up a cheap 5 yards, and he did it that play.
All right, three wide receivers to the near side. Central's now left to right. This one, a quick hitter up the middle. Nice positive yardage right there for Central. You see the big guys underneath on that. That was Keon Waters right there. But you see some of the blockers in there. Isaac, like big number 36, Hunter Apt.
Yeah, good job by Josh Unlin as well, coming from his linebacker position and getting in on that tackle. That's one of the things you're going to have to do if you're Francis Howell, is gang tackle these running backs.
Second down and two. Uh-oh, fumble back in the backfield. And they lose about 7 yards on that right there. I'm not sure if it was a bad snap or what, but let's take a look.
I think he wants to hand this ball off. He never caught it clean. He just never caught it clean, took his eye off the ball, wanted to hand that ball off, but a good play of just diving on that ball, keeping the possession. This is a very quick strike offense. And you see what these linemen are doing. They're all looking at their wrists. They all have wristbands on, and the coach from the sideline throws out a number, and they look down at their wristband and see what play is called.
And this time they fake it to the right side. Pump fake it. Burke drops it, rolls to his right side. He keeps rolling. He's up to about the 40, turns a corner out of bounds at the 42-yard line. Great athletic ability. Gain of about five right there. It's going to bring up fourth down. And
I think this was supposed to be a throwback, a screen to the left. Fake it, fake the screen right, and then come back and throw
Waters
the screen
covered,
to the left.
Yeah.
Yes, but Waters is covered, so now he has to throw this ball away right now. The play is dead, because you have no receivers going down the field because it's a screen. Don't take the hit, just throw it away.
And actually they do a quick kick this time as they kick it down. Oh, it takes a very nice bounce for Howell Central. That ball rolls all the way down to about the 14-yard line, where it's down by Nathan Garth. And we'll keep it right here, folks, as the Francis Howell Vikings will take over first and 10 with 9:36 and a lot of momentum, Isaac. I do think that was smart to punt right there, because doing the onside kick, you put the Vikings in perfect position with a short field to come on down. They made a couple of big plays, a nice big pass. Then they pushed it in the end zone there at the end. But you know, I just want to ask Pete Eberhardt, why did you do that?
Yeah, right now, and it's about the defense now. I mean, you got them right around the 15-yard line. If you can force a three and out here, if you can force a three and out and get the ball back, you should get it in plus territory.
All right, McGuire throws it. It's knocked down at the line of scrimmage. That'll bring up second down and 10, 9:34 to go here in the second quarter. You're watching the Bommarito Automotive Group High School Prep Zone, Week 7, Isaac.
I know, already. The season seems like it's flying by. And we have two very good teams here in the Spartans. This is a very big possession here. If they can get off the field, make them punt, they should get the ball in good field position.
All right, McGuire shoots out to the right side over the middle, and he's got his man for the first down up close to the 30-yard line. So, yeah, McGuire wastes no time there.
Yeah, the defense is way too soft. That safety who's covering that slot receiver, he was literally 12 yards off the receiver. When you just can't be that far off. That's an easy pitch and catch first down.
9:23 to go in the first half. Vikings with the ball. McGuire looks out to the left side, he throws, and it's caught. And up to the 45, close to midfield. And a nice play right there. And that one was complete to number 7, Dalen Dalton.
Very good catch by Dalton. He just runs a quick hitch here. There's the hitch, gets up and makes the catch, and watch the speed there. Get around the edge, stiff arm. Very good job running after the catch.
And how about that camera work right there on the sideline? It just came right into the screen. Looked like you're on the 50-yard line close up. First down, 10 yards to go. Dean takes it himself around the left side, pushes down to about the 42-yard line. So McGuire, you got to like that. Running quarterback with a lot of poise. He can throw it and he can run it.
Yeah, but this offensive line is doing a really good job. Nathan O'Donohue on that play, 6'1", 225. The tackle, left tackle, just completely destroyed his man on that left side. Very good job. And as long as this offensive line can control the line of scrimmage, they're going to be able to do anything they want offensively when it comes to running and throwing the football. There's that big, strong offensive line. That's one of the strengths of this team.
All right, ball at the 42-yard line. The Howell Vikings going right to left. This time they hand it off to Jones around the right side. He jukes outside, turns the corner, spins it up. And it gets down about the 33-yard line where he's knocked out of bounds.
Very good blocking again, especially watch number 89, Zach Hunsicker. Right there on your right side, he's going to get a really good block. And watch him stay on his man. There's the block there. Watch him continue to drive him up the field, down the field, stay on him. Very good job. And, of course, you have the back that has the speed to get around the edge.
Cole Kreider finally knocked him out of bounds after a nice gain right there. And that brings up second down for the Vikings. This time McGuire hands it off to Jones up the middle. And it looks like he got the first down somewhere around the 33-yard line.
That's a very good tackle by Luke Ezell, the senior D lineman. Very good tackle. This D line is going to have to, of Central, is going to really have to stand up here. They're starting to get pushed around just a little bit. Central's D line is starting to get pushed around a little bit. You may see those safeties starting to drop down in that box to help out on the run.
All right, so he was just a little bit short. We're going to call it third down at about 6 inches with 8:20 to go here in the first half. Man in motion to the near side. And McGuire fakes it, keeps it himself. He gets the first down and rolls outside to the left side. He's got his ball on the right side. Spins down the 5-yard line, down to the 1. So McGuire, unbelievable how he's taken over this ball game here in the second quarter.
Absolutely. And a very good block by the receiver, Dalton. Right around, you know, right when he was about to turn up the field, Dalton, who came in motion, took the fake. Went around the edge and then picked up the linebacker that really gave the run to the quarterback a chance to get the edge and get around and down the sideline.
First and goal, Vikings, ball at the 4-yard line. McGuire hands it off this time up the middle to number five, Jack Flynn. Jack Flynn, 6'1", 190 junior. We're going to take a look at the run before that in our Harris Stowe University replay.
Now here comes the motion, man. Now watch him as he gets the fake. Dalton comes around right here. Not a big block, just enough to sprint him down the field. You think he's going out of bounds. He doesn't, put his foot in the ground and gets back up the field, picks up more yards.
This time it's a rush right up the middle. Bowling forward, moving the pile forward just a little bit. Looks like number 45. I want to say that's 45, Chase Goulet.
And Central needs to make a stand. This is important. They cannot go down here by 2 scores. They really need to make a stand. I expect everyone to be on the line of scrimmage here.
Here we go, into the end zone, touchdown. I haven't seen the official arms go up, but the Viking looks to be in the end zone, but
all the
there we go.
Yeah, all the refs are in the end zone. So.
I want to see this one on the replay, because they bull forward right there. Looked like, again, number four. Just kept it himself, and he got the big push from behind, Isaac. Big number 45. And number 72 got right on McGuire's back. 72, that's Cameron Miles. And number 45, of course, Chase Boulay. PAT was good. And that makes the score 28-16. Francis Howell Vikings with 6:55 to go here in the first half.
I was sick of working dead-end jobs. I wanted to have a career. Battle.ai gave me the hands-on experience to build my future. The teachers were very good.
The purpose of them coming to Battle.ai is to learn a trade. As an instructor, I'm gonna be there for them.
They just made me feel like a brand new person. He's been working with me for some years, and I'm proud of him and the things that they have instilled in him.
I wanted to follow my dad's footsteps, but now I figured out through Battle.ai, I could be better than my dad. Battle.ai had really changed my life.
Tonight's telecast is brought to you in part by Millennium Restoration and Development, restoring neglected buildings throughout the St. Louis region.
Well, they have a different gentleman that is going to kick it right now, Joe Recca, also a defensive lineman. He likes to get a little loft, and does he ever. Kicks it down, short kick to about the 28-yard line, but there's a whistle on the field. The offsides against Francis Howell. So they're going to go ahead and re-kick this. All right, we're going to take a look at the replay, Isaac, and let's see if we can see the offsides.
Boy, that is real tight.
It looks like maybe at the top of the screen up there.
Yeah, maybe.
That was a tough call. Yeah. I was like, that's an instant replay call.
Yeah, usually
call right there.
You want it, whenever it's offside, you usually want the guy to be a good full yard offside where it's obvious. Now, he may have had a half a step out offside a little bit. But hey, sometimes the referees want to get a little bit of TV time too. You know, so he wants to get on TV.
Well, Recca boots it this time. He puts a little bit of oomph behind it, and it bounces around.
And that ball's loose.
I'd tell you what, Faxon played with trouble right there. That's the thing about the football, though. It's never a true bounce.
Yeah, if he doesn't pick this ball up, I mean, this is going to be the Vikings football. So now he's going to kick this ball deep. And when he does, this ball gets loose on the ground. And he did a really good job of just falling on it.
Yeah, here it is right here. You see it bounce. And just bounces out of his stretch. But now he doesn't know it's like a hot potato.
Right there is when.
Oh, yeah. Big scare right there for Central. Burke hands it off to Waters on the left side. Keon maybe gets back in line of scrimmage. 6:45 to go here in the second.
And here's, this is their philosophy here. These are the guys on the sideline. They have the numbers that they're just going to give. And everyone is looking at their wrist. Everyone has a wristband. So one of these guys are live. The other two are a dummy. And now you have all the entire offense who's looking at their wrist to know what play is called. This is more of a college-style offense, a philosophy.
Burke back of the 11-yard line. He hands it off to Keon Waters around the right side. Keon goes airborne, flying past the 20-yard line. Shows some athleticism right there. Let's take a look at our Harrisville University replay. Look at this, Isaac.
Comes around the right-hand side, Looks like it'll be a getaway to Holden. Watch him go airborne right here.
Right over good Jones.
Job. Yes. And Josh Unlin does a good job of bringing him down.
Alex Jones went down. The running back also plays defense. He went down.
Yeah, they have this college system going on here, which is pretty cool. So,
timeout.
Looks like there'll be a timeout.
We're in a timeout right now. This one's going to be charged to Howell Central. It's going to be charged to the Vikings. Yeah, Howell Central. I saw 21 out there, and he's been running the ball so much. He dove down at the running back, Keon Waters' legs right there, and Waters just dove right over the top of him. Very athletic.
Yeah, it looks like what the Spartans do, they have three or four guys on the sideline, and they all have two guys have a number, and another two guys have a couple of logos and signs. So, you know, one of those guys is the actual call. He's the live one. Maybe it's the first guy to the left. The other guys are just the demo guys. So if he holds up maybe a number one, look at this. You got the Pac-Man. You got the Green
Bay
Packers. You got the Ford sign. You know, so this is more of like a college. I tell you who started this. It was really Oregon. Maybe, I want to say, 6-7 years ago.
Chip Kelly?
Yes, with Chip Kelly, with that fast-paced offense that really started, that it just gets the play called, it gets the play in quicker.
Nothing like stealing signs. Here we go, Burke out the left side, out to the flat. He's got a man, and a pretty nice gain as they push the ball up to about the 25, 26-yard line of Faxton, and Faxton, I think, is just a little short of the first down. Fourth down for the Spartans. Will they go for it again deep in their own territory?
Well, normally you would punt this ball away, but you're under 5 minutes here. You're down by two scores.
But it's only the second quarter.
Yeah, but your defense haven't done much to slow the offense down.
So you give them a short field to score. It is a short. Maybe they tried to draw them off sides.
Well, now it's going to be a false start. Yeah, that's going to move them back any further. So now you go from 4th-and-1 and 4th-and-6, so it just makes it that much tougher.
So Pete
it looks like the tight end at the top. Watch at the very top of your screen.
That great
he's
camera.
He's going to raise up right
oh,
there.
Yeah. It looked like moving on both sides at the same time simultaneously. You know Pete Everhart was trying to get him to draw off sides. Now they're doing a quick kick, which is very smart. Punt, put a lot of loft in that. This time it bounces back, but it settles at about the 42-yard line.
That's fine.
Much better field position as a defense than having you pinned back, around your 25, 28-yard line.
Yeah, as a defense right now, if you're central, you just have to start bringing more pressure. You're going to have to maybe force two turnovers here, maybe one now and one in the second half to really stay in this game. But just playing a base vanilla style offense and hope that you're able to stop this offense this offense is going to be tough. So I'm expecting to bring their linebackers down, their safeties down, to try to put in some kind of pressure on this offense.
All right, Vikings ball. First down, 10 yards to go. And McGuire keeps it after a fake, keeps around the right side, gets a gain of about four up to midfield, Isaac, where it'll be about second down and 6 yards with 4:22 to go in the first half.
Good job by the Spartans being really disciplined. Those linebackers saw that the fake was up the middle, didn't go forward. They stayed in their lane, came up and made the tackle. So that's a win for them on first down.
All right, three wide receivers split to the near side. Jones alone set back in the backfield. And they fake it. McGuire keeps it. He's past midfield, then he goes back, gets back, and he wills his way to about the 45. And right now we're going to go down to Angela with a special guest.
That's right. I've got Matt Bierman with the Elite Football Academy. Great to have you here again today.
Yeah, we're happy to be here. It's good. Last week we're up in Illinois and Edwardsville, and now we're out in St. Charles County. So getting to see kids all over the metro area, which we get to see kids coming to our facility from all over the metro area, so it's neat to get out here and see a lot of kids that we know play.
I know. I like we're covering the whole area. Who here do you train?
We have McGuire Dean. I've got to mention him, the quarterback who's actually playing right now. Excellent young man. He's kind of waited his turn at Howell. We've trained a ton of Howell quarterbacks over the years. So getting to watch him playing, he's got a couple touchdowns already, so excited. But there's many boys on both sides of the ball that we work with that come in, and whether they do speed and agility training, strength training, or their football skills, they're coming in and doing their work for their team, but then going above and beyond and being the best football player they can be.
We love that. And, you know, we've always talked about you have that little kids can join up. But we like to mention that, you know, if somebody's just now starting football, they're a little older than the little kids, but they want more practice, more help.
Yeah, right. I mean, a lot of times the trouble with the game is there's the side of the game where kids are actually learning how to execute offense and defensive sets or schemes, and what's difficult is they actually know how to play that position, but a lot of time is really spent developing the skill sets necessary to play the game. So that's where we specialize, and we do that with NFL players, college players, and guys just like the high school and middle schoolers that we're going to watch play this weekend. So it's just as simple as learning to perfect the skills that you can use on the field of play and to become a best, you know, teammate you can be, and then ultimately help yourself reach the goals that you set.
That's right, and you can set any kind of goals. We had DeSmet's coach who's coaching now, and yeah. Anything, you can do anything.
Right. I mean, it can be as simple as, hey, I want to get on the field, or I have dreams and aspirations to play in college and get my education paid for, or I want to play in the NFL. I mean, those are a variety of skills and dream or skill sets that set yourself up to accomplish those goals, right? And so I think it's neat to see that football is a launching pad for so many kids to gain self-confidence, be a better teammate, learn what it is to play through adversity and the joys of winning, all that fun stuff, but then also set yourself up for later on in life, because eventually you got to retire. The game ends eventually.
The game ends eventually. Actually, I think we're going to get a touchdown right here. Oh, wow. We did. We got a touchdown right there. How can somebody get in touch with you and join Elite Football Academy?
The easiest way is to come in and do a free trial class with us. We have football skills classes every Sunday throughout the year, and then speed and agility classes Monday through Friday. And it's elitefootball.net is the easiest way to find us.
Perfect. Thank you so much. Back to you, Todd and Isaac. A lot to talk about.
All right. So touchdown with Joe Wilkoff right there from Dean McGuire that makes the score 34-16. And the PAT is up and good. 5 for 5 on PAT attempts tonight for Jackson Floria. And that makes the score 35-16.
When Chris graduates with his liberal arts degree, his starting salary is $25,000. That's if he can find a job. When Steve graduates from MTC Truck Driving School, he'll work for a national company at $50,000 a year. Which route would you take? Hop on at beatrucker.com.
This telecast is made possible through the support of We Do Laundry and their support of high school football.
Well, it started out Howell Central with the big bomb, the 70-yarder to Garth from Burke, and I tell you, the Vikings have really taken over here in the second quarter as Howell Central brings the ball back up to about the 26-yard line, where they'll take over first down 10 yards to go. On your screen, the blue team, the Spartans will be going left to right, and we've got 2:31 to go here in the first half.
Yes, senior quarterback Jackson Burke now is really up against it. This is something that he's seen all year long, down by multiple scores before halftime. And they usually throw a lot in that second half, and a lot of yards are picked up and a lot of points, but they're usually too far to come back. So he's in this situation again. He has the arm and the talent and really the players outside to put up a lot of points, but he's going to have to make it quick here. He's going to have to put up at least 7 more points before the half.
And the senior quarterback on senior night. This time he hands it off. Looks like Keon Waters up the middle. Spins around. He drops it. fumbles and is picked up by the Vikings. Down inside the 10-yard line, the Vikings picked up by number 55, Aaron Lewis, very heads-up play after Keon puts it on the turf.
Yeah, right when you think they're going to throw the ball and try to get this ball down the field, they try to run it here right to the right, and he has the ball in his right hand, very good there, and then the ball is just stripped right out. Looks like number 5 stripped it, Jack Flynn. The linebacker comes up and strips the ball, and they pick it up and run it down the field. Exactly what the Vikings needed. Now they're in a very good position here. It's first and goal just under 3 minutes before the half.
Yeah, I'd tell you, Josh Unland in there as well with his big paw. Kind of pushes that one out. And once again, the Vikings are in the red zone. McGuire hands it off to Jones around the right side. Inside the 5, diving down towards the end zone. Touchdown! And there's a penalty on the play. But Jones did get into the end zone for a touchdown.
Look at that big offensive line. This offensive line,
looks like
Vikings,
LSU.
I tell you, they have really took over this game. I mean, they've done a really good job. There's Walker, number 77. There's Funk, number 72. Then they have 53, O'Donohue. They've done a really good job of taking over this game at the line of scrimmage. Looks like a personal foul as well on Central.
So the touchdown's going to be good, which puts 41 points up in the first half.
In the first half.
For the Vikings.
And if you remember, the Vikings fell behind in this game. It was a 4th-and-8, and Central hits them deep for about 65, 70 yards down the right sideline. They go up 8-0, then they go up 16-7. But after that, it's been all of the Vikings. Now look at this big offensive line doing a great job there. He gets right in behind him. No, watch the power. There's the power and the strength to get inside and get into the end zone. I'm trying to see where that flag was thrown late. I can't imagine on who.
Well, the referees are sorting it out right now, but Francis Howell is certainly taking charge in this ball game in the second quarter.
Yes, as I said earlier, it's that big offensive line. They're really just that's putting their weight, really, on Central. They're just moving them out of the way, and they have anything they want to do offensively, running, passing, whatever they want to do, they have it because that offensive line is doing such a great job.
And Foria with a PAT makes it 42-16. Francis Howell. With 2:16 to go here in the second quarter. What you're watching, the Bommarito Automotive High School Prep Zone, week number 7. And Isaac Bird, Todd Blackside bringing the call. We've got Angela Sharp down, doing a fine job on the sideline. And Angela has a lot of fun with the St. Louis Blues. And I know the St. Louis Blues season just started. So, you know, when any time you go down to a Blues game, you'll see Angela all over the place having fun. So I wanted to give her a nice plug. Now I want to ask you this, Isaac. It's kind of getting a little chilly. Is this the coldest night of the season so far as we transition into autumn, you know, into the winter months soon?
It really is, but you can't tell the Vikings or Francis Howell that because they are just as hot as you want to be offensively and defensively. I mean, they've thrown a shutout here in this second quarter. They were down, remember, 16-7, I believe. And then they've ran off 35 straight points as they marked the personal foul 15 yards off on the kickoff. So they're going to actually kick this ball off at around a 45-yard line. Now, if you're going to squib or do an onside, this would be the time to do it. Because even if you don't get it, the other team will start at the 35-yard line.
All right. Recca for the run-up and the kick. And this time he boots it down towards the end zone. It's taken at about the 2-yard line by Fax, and he brings up, breaks the tackle, breaks past the 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. Thaxton knocked out of bounds. Just past where the kickoff took place at about the 48-yard line. So a nice play, a nice kickoff return right there. Let's take a look at it right now from our Harris Stowe University replay.
Yeah, what they want to do, they want to just kick it up high in the air and have their defense get down there because they got a 15-yard really head start. But a really good job of splitting the defense there, getting to the sideline. Now you see the straight speed. So really good job of giving this offense now a chance. Now Central really has a chance starting at around the 47-yard line to try to put something together. 2:08 to go before half. They need to try to put something together. I don't think they're going to run it here. I think they'll just do it with an air attack.
Davian Sanderson knocking Thexton out of bounds right there at the 47. Where Central takes over, first and 10. Burke rolls on the right side. And there's a flag on the play as Burke dives forward into Viking territory. But there is a flag, and they're going to call a hold on the Spartans right now, and that's going to nullify that play right there with positive gains.
Yeah, it's really tough on the offensive line when the quarterback starts to scramble. The offensive lineman really doesn't know that the quarterback is scrambling. So, yeah, there's the hold right there, number 77. Really quick hold. It really didn't, you know, it wasn't a devastating hold or anything like that, but he did grab him. It's just a real tough when the offensive lineman, for the offensive lineman, when the quarterback starts to scramble.
Yeah, that was on Dominic Pooney, 6'5", 225-pound junior. And there's a shot of him right there on the side. It's kind of an upright stance right there. It's easier to pass protect, but this is a run right now. Keon Waters right up the middle for a couple of gains, a couple of yards right there as we're under 2 minutes in the first half.
Yeah, good play there by Reader Kuhn, who's coming in, you know, the senior coming in from his D-line position, wrapping him up. This may be a situation where the, you know, Central really may just want to get in the locker room here. You're under 2 minutes, and you're right around 35-yard line. You're going to go. You better pick up a chunk yard right here.
All right, this time Burke hands it off up the middle. There goes Keon. Keon breaks a tackle, and he goes all the way inside the 40-yard line. Keon Waters zips one right up the middle. Big first down right there for Howell Central, and let's take a look.
Right up the middle. Watch the burst and the speed right there. Very good job. Dean with a touchdown saving tackle. That is a very good open field tackle on a runner that usually doesn't go down with just one defender, especially in the open field.
Yeah, that's McGuire Dean, the quarterback. And this one's off to Keon Waters on the left side. He gets it down to the about the 34-yard line.
Now they're out of timeouts, and it's under a minute, so it's gonna have to be a sense of urgency here. With no timeout, they gotta get this play called and get everyone positioned correctly, and then get this ball down the field. Now you're under 30 seconds. Too much time.
All right, so Burke stands back at the 38-yard line, takes a three-step drop. He throws it downfield, and it's caught. It's caught all the way down inside the 20-yard line at about the 17-yard line by Joe Farron.
Yeah, you give Burke any time at all, he's going to complete a pass. He throws such a pretty ball. He has this really short, it's almost like a short arm, just a flick of the wrist. Watch how this ball just comes out right on a line. Very good location. Gives the receivers an easy chance to turn to make that catch.
Yeah, that was Michael Skibo, the 5'10", 180-pound running back on that. Nice catch right there. This one's intended for number 18 right there. That's Cameron Outlaw, in and out of his hands. And we'll remember when Outlaw dropped one earlier in the game, it hit him right in his hands and face mask. So they want to get back and get him a catch, get him some confidence.
Yeah, Outlaw had a very good block right before that play, then dropped one that was right in his hands. He's a big cog in this. He's a big player now in his offense. They want to try to get him going. He usually catches the ball with his hands, and when he gets it now, he's got some speed. You get him in the open field, he can make some guys miss.
We got four wide receivers here on the near side. Burke, naked backfield. He's got a little bit of time. Looks to the left side, rolls to the left side. And he runs out of bounds at about the 12-yard line. Nice play right there by Burke. He flooded this field to the right side, and he went back to the naked side. All the momentum had come over to this side of the field, Isaac, and he made a nice little run, got out of bounds.
Great job getting out of bounds. That's just recognizing that he has no more timeouts. If he gets tackled right there in play, the clock might run out. So that's a very good job knowing that he has nothing and getting out of bounds to stop the clock.
All right, Keon Waters in the backfield with Burke. Wide receiver split. Faxton in motion to the near side. And the ball's thrown down towards the end zone and overthrown right there as the intended receiver was Connor Rybal. And I know that Burke and Coach Pete Everhart want to get him more involved in this ball game.
I don't mind the throw at all. That throw is out of bounds, sure, but you just want to give your player an opportunity to make the catch. If the receiver wasn't going to make that catch, it's going to fall short or fall out of bounds. That gives you a shot to come back and fourth down and make it, and to try to complete a pass for a touchdown. You got to throw this ball into the end zone because you only have 7 seconds left.
All right, Burke back to pass about the 21-yard line. He rolls to his right side. He's got a little bit of room. He throws towards the end zone. And nice defensive play right there as they knock it down.
It's going to be a penalty, pass interference. They're going to put that ball right there on the 1 yard line.
And there's zero time on the clock, but the half cannot end on a defensive penalty.
Yeah, it'll be an untimed play here at the 1 yard line. As you see, the quarterback rolls a little bit to his right. He's buying time, trying to waiting for one of his receivers to get open. Then he throws a dart, and there's the flag right there. He hits him right before the ball gets through, just got there just a little bit early. That's going to make it an untimed down at the 1 yard line.
It looks like that was on number 14, Max Heffler.
Pass interference.
So we'll have one play here. And this is a big play for Howell Central right now, Isaac. I mean, if they can get on the board again and get this to 22, you're only down 3 touchdowns going into the second half.
Yeah, and I say untimed down at the 1. It's not going to be at the 1. It's actually going to be around the 14-yard line as it is a 15-yard penalty. So it is one untimed down, so they have to get it into the end zone. Good job right here, I believe, by the Vikings calling timeout, making sure they get their defense set, making sure their defense understands, listen, they're going to throw this ball into the end zone, and we got to come up with a big stop here.
So I guess the line of scrimmage looks to be about the 7-yard line. So it's a half the distance to the goal on that penalty. So here we go. After the timeout, the home time, it's senior night. They want to put one in before halftime, Isaac, so get some inspiration. They can get a little pep talk from Coach Everhart and come out flying in the second half. And here we go. Burke about the 12-yard line. Waters to the far side in motion. He throws to the near side. Touchdown! Wow, unbelievable. It's almost too good to be true right there. The Spartans come up with a big touchdown right at the end of the first half.
Very good, strong throw. He stands right there in the pocket. He knows what he wants. He wants the slant. Watch him reach out and pluck that ball out of the air. Great job catching that ball right out of the air. That was Garth again. Great hands getting into the end zone. Now they're going to go for two like they have all night.
Garth's second touchdown of the night, 12th on the season right now. As Burke rolls to the right side, he's trying to get in for the 2-point conversion, and he's in! So what a way to go into halftime. Francis Howell Central, they cut the score to 42-24, and most importantly, Isaac, they go into halftime with some momentum and hope for the second half.
He wants to do the shuffle pass right there and doesn't like it. Now he just uses his speed, gets outside, dives in, knocks down the pylon, gets the 2-point conversion. Now they go into half with a more manageable score of 42-24, try to figure some things out at half.
And right now we're going to go down to Angela Sharp.
I've got, Coach, now you're up 42-24. What are some things that you're really proud of the guys for doing well?
You know, I thought we came out very strong offensively, running the ball really well, taking advantage of passing opportunities. So offensively, I think we're playing really well right now.
Well, is there anything you're going to go in there and try to clean up for the second half?
Yeah, I mean, I think defensively we've got to get a few more stops, a little pass coverage on late downs and do that. Offensively, we just need to keep doing what we're doing.
So you're pretty pleased. I like that. That's pretty easy to go into the half kind of pleased.
Yeah, I mean, it's nice to be up, but you can't, you know, it's two halves, and so we got to go in like a whole new ball game.
A whole new ball game. Well, good luck to you, Coach.
Thanks, appreciate it.
Back to you, Todd and Isaac.
And you're listening to the Bommarito Prep Zone. We'll be right back.
Doesn't it seem like the wireless world today could use a smile? At Cricket Wireless, we think so.
2-year contract.
That's why with us, you don't have to worry about annual contracts. Prices for our plans are all in, taxes and fees included. And we've got more 4G LTE coverage nationwide than T-Mobile or Sprint. That's a whole lot of network for not a lot of dough. It's what makes Cricket the happiest place in the whole wireless world. Cricket Wireless, something to smile about.
Precision, consistency, accuracy. That's Dead On Sports.
Tonight's telecast is brought to you in part by Millennium Restoration and Development, restoring neglected buildings throughout the St. Louis region.
Fourth down of their own 12, and they do a quick kick, which is that's very smart. And they got a good roll, too. Burt gets a great roll all the way down to about the 35-yard line. So, you know, they're going to give their defense a little breathing room right there. And we're going to head down to Angela Sharp on the sideline. Angela!
Hey there. I have the Lions Choice family of the game. It's the Schuster family. So, now, some of these are your kids. The dancing one here is yours. Who else is yours?
This one, Isabella, and this is Lucas.
That's right. And they're up here. You're up here cheering for Central. Anybody in particular?
Jackson Burke.
That's who you're cheering for. And how do you know the rest of these people?
These are just some friends of ours from our church in our high school group. So.
Well, I am going to make your day. What I have here is a gift card of Lions Choice, $50 gift card, so you can take the kids out later, have some fun with Lions Choice.
Oh, thank you. That's awesome.
Real roast beef, real great. There's plenty of locations around. You should also check out Lions Choice. All right, give me a Go Central. They need it.
Go Central.
Yeah, why not? Why not get your field goal kicker out there? I mean, you're going to be going into district soon. You're going to be playing in postseason. You want to get everybody up to speed. Everybody needs to get some action. Ooh, the snap's high. Kick's definitely long enough, and it's good.
It was a place like Harrah-Stowe that took a chance on me as a first-generation college student from a single-parent household. A place like Harrah-Stowe provided me an educational opportunity that allowed me to be the youngest college president in the country. Harrah-Stowe has amazing degree programs. We have one of the most quality, affordable educations in this region. Small classroom environment, family environment, very welcoming to all students, and be prepared to be a global leader in a global society, Harrah-Stowe is the place for you.
For more than a century, the St. Louis Carpenters Union has shaped St. Louis. Through trusted alliances, we deliver skilled professional craftspeople, while our business partners provide the kind of quality jobs that keep our economy humming. It's a blueprint that has worked since 1882. A career in union carpentry means great pay, exceptional benefits, and professional skills training unmatched in the industry. We are 20,000 members strong, and we work for St. Louis. Visit carpdc.org to learn more.
Tonight's telecast is brought to you in part by Noodles & Company. Real food, real cooking, real flavors, with locations all around Metro St. Louis.
And here is the H&R block of the game. Watch this offensive line. Watch them fire off, stay low. Look how low they are. They're under the pads of the central team, and watch they move them into the end zone. All the blue shirts are in the end zone. That's going to ease up. That's going to be a very easy walk-in for a touchdown. That is the H&R block of the game.
We'd love to thank Silverback Video for all the great things they do. Andre Holman, Tom Williams, and the gang. Great job. And here's a nice play, pitch and catch right there from Burke up to Michael Skibo. And that will do it. The final score, Francis Howell, 59. Francis Howell, Central, 24. And right now we're going to go down to our sideline reporter, Angela Sharp, with
I have the Carpenters Regional District Council Player of the Game, McGuire Dean. You led this team to quite the victory. What was that like for you?
It was pretty awesome to come out here in our last game against our rival here. Last game for our seniors against them is fun. Awesome.
Are you going to use this game as you go ahead into playoffs and whatnot?
Yes, we'll definitely look back on this to know what we can do when we're having down days. And this is just good for us to know we can do this.
Now, you mentioned the rivalry. It is a big rivalry between these two teams. Does that make this win even more sweet?
Yes, definitely, yes. Especially our senior year, definitely.
Well, you are the player of the game. They talked about you all game. So thank you very much, and congratulations. Back to you, Todd and Isaac.
Alex Jones was the workhorse tonight. 25 carries, you know, it puts in another 2 yards and then another two touchdowns. So it's really flipping a coin when it comes to Dean and Jones, you know, and we talked about it later in the fourth quarter about, you know, once they get this running game going, he's going to be really tough to start. Look at him come right in, right behind the line. Watch him get down and get. He's always falling forward is what you like in a running back. You want them always to fall forward. He does a really good job of that.
And right now we're going down to Angela with the hard hat player of the game.
The batter at hard hat player of the game, Nathan Garth. They've been talking about y'all game. It was a losing effort, but you put in a lot of work for that.
Yeah, we went out there. We fought hard. We obviously didn't come out with the outcome that we wanted, but we fought our butts off, and that's all we can ask for on our senior night.
Yeah, just to do the best you can. You're a senior, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So does that make this loss hurt a little bit more?
Yeah, it makes it hurt, especially because it's our rivals. It's bittersweet.
Bittersweet?
I love playing on this field, and it sucks I'm not going to be able to do it again.
Well, you know what? At least when you did it, you are the hard hat player of the game, which means you worked hard. So thank you very much for that, and enjoy the rest of your senior year.
Thank you.
Back to you, Todd and Isaac.
Thank you so much for watching the game today. 59-24, Francis Howell Vikings over the Francis Howell Central. That's right, folks. We'll see you next week right here in the Bommarito Automotive Prep Zone High School Game of the Week.